Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Movie Nightcap, friends drinking beer, talking movies. I am one of your hosts, Nate Fisher, and I'm joined, as always, by
Abe Saffer.
So today, for the first episode of the Reserve Collection, we are going to be doing a pairing of beer pairings and movie stories. And so with that, we have a special guest joining us, a beer guru. And Abe, I'm going to let you introduce our guest.
Thank you, Nate. A friend of mine I've been friends with for a while now who got me down the road of beer, finding out what I liked. Is it malty? Do I like hoppy? Do I want it bitter? I don't even know what any of these things meant before I met Josh. So Josh Greenberg is joining us.
Hi, guys. Thanks for having me.
Thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for coming on.
So he's going to take us on our journey as we bring everyone with us to really develop their palate.
Yeah.
They should be. Because beer is an experience, not just a way of getting someplace.
Yeah, that's right. So we're in for an array of different tastes and beer types today, and we're going to let Josh walk us through each one of those, and then we'll also point them out so you can try them yourself. And this is going to be a great palate introduction episode of this new collection, to where you get to know a little about us, beers we like, and types of movie experiences we had. So
let's get right to it.
So the first beer today is called Creme Brulee Imperial Stout. It's from a brewery called Southern Tier, which is out of New York. This beer is a beer that anyone should like, beer drinkers, non-beer drinkers, because it tastes an awful lot like creme brulee in a glass.
Awesome.
Yeah, it's pretty great. is 10% alcohol, so you want to pace yourself when drinking this. I believe it's also a lot of calories, which nobody really cares about, right?
Mm-mm.
So
you can't play that game if you're a beer fan.
Exactly.
You really just, you're not a diet podcast.
So the way I think about beer is there are three flavor drivers. There's the malt, which is the grains. There's yeast. And then there's hops. And all three of those work together to make the beer. And so what I've done is we're going to start with the three basic flavors. We're going to have a beer that's characteristically one of those flavor drivers.
Awesome. Which one is
so
this?
This is going to be the malty beer.
Ooh.
Now, it also has some additives in it to make it especially creme brulee-y.
Mm-hmm.
So I think there's some vanilla, et cetera, in it. But the primary thing driving the flavor of this beer is the malt.
It's the malt. Awesome.
So we are starting with this.
And just for the listeners, so I think it's fair to say everyone at this table, our taste buds go toward the malt, you know, or like, you know, the heavier side of beers. But we're going to try a bunch of like hoppy.
Try to branch out.
Yeah.
I will say that I will make my own beer and it'll be the maltier ones. But I enjoy...
You enjoy
the, I enjoy
well.
The rainbow. They all have their...
The beer rainbow.
Yeah.
Every beer has its place in your
he's
fridge.
He's like the Skittles of beer.
I am. Well, the Skittles connoisseur. The Skittles of the rainbow.
Taste
it's
the rainbow,
fine.
Yeah.
You know, we'll get there, though. But let's pop it open and try this one. Because I don't know if I've ever had this one before.
Yeah, me neither.
So,
but I will have...
Nice carbonation pop there. So pour a little
bit
out.
Wow, look how smooth that pours.
Yeah, it's... It's dark.
Awesome. Thank you,
very
sir.
Dark beer. Get you some, too. Remember, this is 10%, so...
Brace yourselves.
You know, bottoms up.
Yeah.
So if you look at it, it's extremely dark. The darkness comes from the malt. That's where the color comes from, is from the grains.
It's got a heavy aroma, too. Well, I'm noticing that.
Yeah, so that's a lot of the aroma is the probably the vanilla, but also some of the malt.
Gotcha.
And to the first episode of the Reserve Collection.
Yeah, cheers, guys. Cheers,
cheers
to you listening.
Cheers. Oh, that is good.
Wow.
Oh,
like
man.
Like I said, this beer, if you're trying to get someone into beer, someone that claims they hate beer, this is my go-to beer for that person.
That's awesome.
They're going to like this beer.
I want to get
if
married.
If they don't, there's something wrong with them.
I want to get married again, and instead of having cake, have this. Just cut this and just pop it open and give it to all the guests.
I totally am experiencing what you described, though, Josh, where the main flavor is coming from the malt, but it's almost like that the softness and the sweetness of the vanilla.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.